Hey everyone, welcome back to an exciting new video, this time using Appian RPA. Now we all know Appian RPA is a great time saver, assigning tasks to robots, allowing workers to focus on more cognitive, interesting work. Now in this video, I'm going to introduce a use case, explain how Appian RPA can help, as well as build and execute a robotic task. Now the use case we're going to dive into is the Acme Design Studio Agency. So let's get started and let's learn about their needs. Acme Design Studio is a national design agency that receives thousands of invoices per year. When an invoice comes in, a worker reviews the invoice, categorizes it, then enters the data into a legacy application. This process is time-intensive, as it requires an analyst to categorize the invoice and manually update a legacy system. By automating their work, the agency would save thousands of hours per year and allow workers to focus on decision-making and managing special use cases. Appian's automation capabilities are perfect to categorize invoices, extract data, and input data into a system, no matter where it lives. Using AI skills, the agency can categorize the invoice based on the supplier, and then extract the data to be used in an Appian process. Once that data is available in Appian, entering the data into a legacy application can be automated using Appian RPA. By using Appian's automation capabilities, Acme Design Studio can automate their daily tasks using the Document Classification AI skill, Document Extraction AI skill, and Appian RPA to enter data into a legacy application. Let's get started. All right, so let's take a look at this workflow. Now, you've already learned that the marketing agency is going to be getting documents and then uploading those documents to AI skills for classification and extraction. And then after it's extracted, then we can take that data from the invoice and load it into a legacy application. So here you can see we have that workflow kind of laid out. Now in our video, we're only focusing on Appian RPA. But you can see how this would work out as a end-to-end solution. Take the data or get the documents, load the documents into AI skills for classification and extraction, and then send that invoice data to Appian RPA for the legacy application. Now, we've been talking about this legacy app, so let me go ahead and bring in a legacy application that we'll use for this video. So here you can see we have a virtual machine, and this virtual machine has this legacy application, and its only purpose in life is to allow us to add invoices or maybe purchase orders. And when we add invoices, we just click add invoice, and then we enter in the invoice number, date, supplier, and total. Now we're going to be creating a robot to do this for us, so that way we can automate this process. Let me go ahead and bring this window back. All right, and let's get into our robotic task design object. Now, some pre-work has already been done for this robotic task. We've already created a robot. We've added that robot to a robot pool. And of course, when we created this robotic task, we connected it to that robot pool. You'll also notice how I've already added some process variables. Now, these process variables are going to be for the fields that we want to pass in to the robotic task so the robot can add it to the legacy app. Values like invoice supplier, invoice number, date, and total. Now your process could have all four of these fields in a CDT, a custom data type, or laid out just like this. For our demonstration, we're just going to have them be separated here for simplicity. Now when we're creating this robotic task, again, the goal is to mimic what a human would do on the legacy application. Now, a lot of these actions we can just recreate using the task recorder. So we're gonna go ahead and do a task recorder for some of the actions, but for others, we'll do a more manual approach. All right, let's go ahead and click Start Recording. So when I click Start Recording, it's gonna ask me which robot do I wanna use. I only have one robot. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that, click OK. Let me bring back my virtual machine, and you'll see the task recorder load up. Once it's loaded up, I just need to go ahead and tell it which application we're going to be using to do the recording. So I'm going to use this dropdown down here, select application, and we're going to go ahead and select legacy application because that's the name of the application that's open. All right. Now, when we look through this legacy application, you'll notice that I have the ability to highlight certain things. Some things are unsupported, but that's okay because we're only focusing on clicking buttons and typing values into fields. So what would this robot do? Well, the robot would click add invoice. So we're going to click add invoice. You'll see how that's recorded in the task recorder. They would also click on the invoice number text field and enter a value. Invoice number 123123, beautiful. You'll see that value is also recorded in the task recorder. Now later, I'm going to be passing in a value that I give it, so 123 will be replaced. But for now, it's a placeholder. Invoice date. Oh, this is an unsupported element, so we're going to have to tackle this a different way. But let's move down to supplier. I'll click on the supplier text field, and again, we'll enter a value of some type. I don't know, supplier. Again, it's a placeholder. And then, of course, total. We'll click on total. And then add sum total. Again, placeholder. We're going to connect it to our process variable later. Finally, the robot will click save. So we click save. That value is now added to the legacy application. And clicking save is also captured in the task recorder. All right, we're now done. So I'm going to click done for the task recorder, name this group, add invoice to legacy app, and add group. All right, so now this is creating those tasks, loading them into my robotic task designer. You'll notice it pop up here, and I'll hit close recorder. All right, let me go ahead and hide my window here, bring it back to the robotic task design object, and you'll see all of those actions recorded. So we have the group add invoice to legacy application, and then switch to legacy app, basically select the application. Then it's going to click the add invoice, then enter the invoice number, the supplier, the total, and then save. So let's go ahead and rename these. I'm going to rename click button to click add invoice. This next one was adding in the invoice number. So type invoice number. All right, next one was typing the supplier. So type supplier. I'll just be like type supplier name. After that, it was the total, so type invoice total. And then this one down here is click save, right? Okay. Now, when they click add invoice, they can now enter the invoice number. And the invoice number is going to be the value that I give it from my process variable, which you'll notice is already a parameter. So when this robotic task triggers, a value from my process will load into the process variable invoice number, and then that value will go into my robotic task, into the robot. So if I scroll down here in my action configuration, I'm going to change the value from 123123 to a variable, and that variable is, of course, my invoice number. All right, I'm going to do the same thing here for supplier. Change that variable to supplier. And invoice total, I'll do the same thing for invoice total. Okay, so the last thing I need to do is invoice date. Now the invoice date was an unsupported element, but that's okay because I can still use window automation capabilities using keyboards, using my keyboard. So as an example, if I bring back my virtual machine, my legacy application, I'm going to click add invoice, and you'll notice that if I use my keyboard, I'll hit tab, I'll hit the right arrow, left arrow, tab. I can still use these keys to navigate around the legacy application. So I can automate that in my robotic task. Okay, so if we're thinking about where the robot is when it's typing the invoice number, after it types in the invoice number, the robot can hit tab to go down to the next field, which would be the date field. So I need a tab key to be pressed after typing in the invoice number. So on the left-hand side with my palette, I'm going to come on down, find my keyboard. There we go. Press keyboard shortcuts. I'll bring this in. And this is going to be for a tab. So under additional keys here, I'll go down to tab. All right, so when I hit tab, this is going to go to date field. Now, specifically when I hit tab, it's going to the month within the date field. That's what's happening. When you hit tab, it goes down to the month of the date field for this legacy application. Could be different for yours. Okay, after it goes down to the month, then it needs to type the month, right? So we're going to do type text again under keyboard. And this will be type the month. The action will be type text. And the text that it types will be the month for my invoice date. So I need an expression that will capture the month from the invoice date process variable. We have an expression called month, which pulls the month out of the date. I'll pass in my invoice date. Okay, and now we're gonna do the exact same thing for the day and the year, but now that we're in the month, I need the keyboard to go to the right to go to the day. So press keyboard shortcut, and we're gonna go to the right. There we go. After it goes to the right, then it's going to type in the day. So type day, action type text. And the text it will type will be the day pulled from the invoice date. And then again, we are doing the right to go to year. And we will type the year. Type year. Text. And the value is pulling from the year function. Year. Invoice date. Okay. So here we have our robotic task. Let's break it down. First thing, when it runs, it's going to choose the legacy application on the VM. Then it's going to click the Add Invoice button, type the invoice number, then tab down to the date field, the month, type in the month. It's going to go to the right using the keyboard, type the day, go to the right, type in the year, and then it's going to click on the type supplier name, invoice total, and then save. All right, I'm gonna hit save changes and let's test. So I'm gonna go ahead and click test. Now, because I have some parameters, invoice number, supplier, date, and total, let's go ahead and pass in some values to see it work. So the invoice number, 123456. Invoice supplier, Acme Co., that's a good one. Invoice date, I don't know. Let's make it a different year just so you can see how it's a little different. All right, an invoice total, I don't know, 1,000. That works. All right, what I'm also going to do is I'm going to choose debugging so I can see what happens at every stage. All right, I'm going to hit test. Let me bring back my VM. Okay, so I've resized some of my windows here so we can see them side by side. And let's go ahead and move through each of these actions. So I'm gonna go ahead and click next action. So again, It's going to go ahead and switch to the legacy app. It's already selected, but that's what it's doing. Then it's going to click add invoice, which it already is on screen, but that's okay. Then we're going to type the invoice number. So let's see that happen. There it is, 123456. Now we are going to tab down to the next field, put in the month, put in the day, and put in the year. Down to supplier, Acme Co., and then down to the total. And then finally, save. All right, and that's it. So we were able to create a robotic task to do the work of a human, something that's highly repetitive, and have a robot do the work for us. So next thing is to put this into a process, pass information in, and then let this process become triggered to run whenever you have new invoices coming in to load into the legacy application. All right, thanks so much for watching. I hope you were able to learn a little bit about how Appian RPA can help you and your business. Now stay tuned, we have some more exciting Appian RPA videos coming soon. Of course, don't forget to check out our courses on Academy Online, and I'll see you in the next one.